time. But as you mentioned at the top, Stephen, getting back to Lynch, it's been a struggle here the last few games. He's held under 10 points the last four games, and unlike last year, you can't point to foul trouble as to the reason for challenge and foul. He needs to see more from his bench. It just can't be the starters that carry the load game in and game out.
That puts a tremendous amount of pressure on your starting five. And like you said, Lynch, he's been pretty good at staying out of foul trouble, you know, so far this season, but the conference play, that could definitely change.
Twice to the miss, but Delph kept it alive. Maybe. And now the denial and a turnover. Good defense that time from Adger. The steal. He'll take it all the way, rattled out, and look at Murphy own that rebound.
Wow. Adger got away with a little travel, I thought, as well.
Now Amir Coffey. Athletic finish.
Schedule there, and they're getting over some injuries, but I still think this is a top three team in the conference. And with the leadership of Nate Mason and the potential explosiveness of this offensive team.
Murphy pulls up. That one's short. And here comes Jalen Ingram.
Good job getting back defensively by the Gophers.
Last year,
sent the message around the league that the Gophers were going to be for real. Prowess of the Gophers, second best in the Big Ten right now. The defense is where they're going to really make the difference moving forward.
Mr. Too Strong and Isaiah Washington, the rebound, coming off his best game in his young career. Last time out, setting up the sharpshooter Harris, and that's his game.
That's typically when young players aren't getting a chance to play, is something on the defensive end.
Seven assists on nine made field goals already. Trauman catch and shoot. That's way off. And that one's tipped over the 5 of 35.
I think freshman. To me, Corey, he can get to the rim at will. I think he needs to put more pressure on the defense as opposed to letting them off the hook.
Two fouls. Heard of the bench and Amir Coffey back in for the Gophers. Trauman will drive and leaves it for Feister.
It's like the Owls trying to work this matchup zone.
Shot clock getting late. And Washington with four. Gophers have to get the ball up here. Washington the heave with two and it. Get off the rim into the hands of Anthony Adger. Good defensive sequence that time for the Owls. Trauman in the corner. The kick for three, and that one.
The rest of his teammates seem to be picking up on that.
Passing inside. Coffey to Lynch to Murphy.
Gophers can do that to you now. Guys can get to the rim. And obviously, Murphy in this position is a handful. But he did get Murphy up, but Jordan readjusted and closed quickly the bottom of that shot. That's good second effort on the defensive end.
Murphy to Mason. Heel and seven-footer Dell playing with two fouls. Spin shoots over Kanate. One rebound ripped down by Feister and he is fouled. Ohio State playing earlier. Mentioned the Wisconsin game still to come. Then tonight a game of interest.
Unique talent, lefty, good length on the perimeter. There's a lot of things that don't show up on the stat sheet.
Murphy against Feister lost it. Shot clock at three. Coffey got it off. It spun out. And Feister the rebound. Season pick, Middle Tennessee State.
Had it rolling there for the last couple seasons.
Gophers, of course, know that program. Yeah. Losing to Middle Tennessee State in the NCAA tournament last year, that 12-5 first round pairing.
But taps it away from Delph.
And McGrayer's absence. Michael Hurt starting his second straight game. He had a good first half. He's got the ball right now. Baseline to Lynch and foul.
Those opportunities there. But we'll go back to Ricky Pitino talking to
Jordan. Getting an FAU with a foul.
You just have to stick with what you're doing right now. You can work on that in all season.
Harris too strong. Feist on clock under 10. Now Washington. Looks like he'll do this on his own.